Victims of domestic abuse and sexual assault are expected to be among the casualties of a wave of council cuts hitting Brighton and Hove next year. The council's Neighbourhoods, Communities and Equalities Committee discussed cuts to its specialist services yesterday, even though more people are reporting instances of abuse.
No decisions have been made yet about our council funding, and we'll do all we can to protect those vital services for women and children escaping domestic and sexual violence. But there's no guarantees. We're facing over £20 million we need to cut from our budget this year. We've already cut £100 million from the overall budget over the last 4 to 5 years. So that shows you the scale of the crisis that we face.
We're not receiving a financial cut. What is happening is that they're moving money from one part of our service to another part. So we've had, for the last year, we've had an unprecedented demand for services in Rise and across the portal. But we haven't had any increase in resources.
I think a lot of it is the outcome of increased confidence as well in reporting, and I think that's really important. But there is also an increase, actually, in domestic violence, violence against women and girls in particular.
Instances of sexual assault and abuse recorded by the police have risen dramatically since 2010. In Brighton and Hove, it's estimated that 7,639 women and girls and 3,868 men and boys have experienced domestic violence and abuse in the last year.
I'm supporting White Ribbon for all the women and girls who feel they need to suffer in silence.
Despite Brighton and Hove Council being asked to accept a reduced budget for their services, Sussex Police have recently increased the amount of resources dedicated to preventing and investigating domestic and sexual abuse. 16 members of staff have also taken part in a campaign for White Ribbon Day, an organisation that opposes domestic abuse and violence against women internationally.
Well, I really supported Sussex Police to get their White Ribbon. They were the first police force in England and Wales that was awarded the White Ribbon status, which I think is fantastic. So Sussex Police, what we've done with the investment that we've got is we've paid for officers who are specially trained, and we've brought all that into one central area in Sussex Police rather than it being held out on division. So we've put a lot of money into helping victims who are victims of serious and sexual offences.
The council is keen to stress that nothing has been decided yet. However, this is unlikely to comfort victims of sexual assault who depend very much on its services. Michael Goodier, Latest TV News.